Good morning, children. Welcome back. We are continuing the chapter Flow of Heat. And we have seen there are three ways the heat can be transferred: conduction, convection, and radiation. First, we have studied conduction with the one activity, then poor and bad conductors of heat, and the application of poor and bad conductors in our day-to-day life. Now, convection. What is convection? Let's do with one activity. Suppose this is a vessel in which water is there. This is water. And one drop of potassium permanganate. I am taking one piece of potassium permanganate. I am drop four. Potassium permanganate. Now I will heat this or boil this by using a flame. Okay. After some time, you can see the potassium permanganate will move up and it moves like this. So what happens? The potassium permanganate melt and the water moves from hot region to the cold region. This is the hot region and this is the cold one. So what is convection? Convection is the process of transfer of heat in which liquid and gases, listen, liquid and gas molecules move, liquid and gas molecules move themselves from hot region to the cold region. So what is convection? Convection is the process of transfer of heat in gas or liquid. The molecules of gas or liquid themselves move, but in conduction the molecules does not move. Molecules only pass the heat energy to the nearby molecules and the heat will be transferred from molecule to molecule in conduction. Whereas in convection, the molecules, heated molecules themselves move from hot region to cold region. This is happening in gas and liquid. So in gas and liquids, the hot molecule or heated molecule move from one place to another place themselves to carry the heat from hot region to the cold region. So when we boil the water, the hot water move from hot molecules move from lower side, that is hotter side. This is the hot region, no? From the cold region. This is what is convection. Very clear? Now, convection takes place in many ways in our life. For example, you can see sea breeze and land breeze. Sea breeze and land breeze. If I do sea breeze, suppose these are the two columns and here it is land and here it is sea. Okay? Here it is land and sea. Land, you can see the land. Land during daytime. And here it is night. Okay. Now let us study the first one. During daytime, the sunlight made the land hotter, faster than the sea. So during daytime, the land gets heated faster than the sea or water in the sea. So also this is the hot air rises up. What rises up? The hot air is warmer and lighter. Hot air is warmer and lighter, it rises up. So the air rises up. Here there is no air. Oh, air is less. Oh, pressure of air is less here because hot air rises up. Okay? As a result, the heavier and lighter, heavier air from the sea, colder air from the sea rush to the land. So the colder and the heavier air rush to the land or blows to the land. This is called a sea breeze. Sea breeze. What is sea breeze? During daytime the land can heat faster than the water in the sea. So the hot air from the land rises up, lighter and they rises up. Now the water and heavier air from the sea blows into the land during daytime. That is called sea breeze. Whereas in land breeze, in the night, what happens? This is the land and this is the sea. Land and the sea. During night, the land gets cooler than, faster and cooler than the sea. Land gets cooler, so the air will remain here. The cooler and heavier air. Heavier usually. The air is heavier. Okay? And during the night, what will happen? Here it is hotter, the sea water is hotter usually. The water, the air from the land moves to the sea. Air from the land moves to the sea. This is called a land breeze. Land breeze. So what is land breeze? During night, the land gets cooler or air is heavier than the sea. So what happens? Comparatively, land is cooler than the water in the sea during night. So what happens? The air from the land blows to the sea. This is called land breeze. Very clear? And now we are coming to the applications of convection. There are many applications of convection. Suppose when we make the home, Usually, the doors and windows, this is the door and this is the window. Doors and windows are built to lower and upper side we make ventilators. What it is? Ventilators. So, this is the door and the window. What happens? During daytime, the hot air inside the room move up. Hot air inside the room move up. This is hot air. Hot air move up and will be moved outside to the ventilator. So ventilators are kept on the top of the window. Okay, top of the wall. Top of the wall. And below the ventilators we will doors and windows. The cold air and heavier air from the outside, you know, enter into the room through the windows. So, the ventilators are built on the top of the wall, just below the roof. So that when the air is cold, it becomes lighter and rises up, there will be lots of escape up through the ventilators. But the air, cold air, heavier air from outside enter into the room through the windows and the doors. So in this way, inside the room, there are developed a movement of the air. This is called a convection current. Convection current inside the room. Got it? Very clear. Thank you.